Assalamualaikum dear students. The topic for today's presentation is invertebrate. Invertebrates. What are invertebrates? Animals which do not have backbone in their body are termed as invertebrates. They are greater in number but usually smaller in size. Invertebrates are divided into many groups or phyla. Number 1, phylum protozoa. Phylum protozoa consist of unicellular microscopic organisms. They occur as free living or as a parasite. They are found in both fresh and marine water. Examples are amoeba, paramecium, euglena. This is the picture of amoeba. This is the picture of paramecium. This is euglena. Next phylum is phylum Porifera. Phylum Porifera consists of multicellular organisms. They lack tissue, means they do not contain tissues. The animals belonging to this phylum have numerous small pores or ostia on their bodies. They are aquatic, means live in water, and sessile, fixed at one place throughout their life. Examples are cycon, bath sponge, and Venus flower basket. This is cycon, bath sponge, and Venus flower basket. Next phylum is phylum Mediaria. This phylum is also called Cnidarians. Animal belonging to this phylum has a special cavity in their body called coelenteron, and thus they are called Cnidarians. They are basically aquatic animals, means they live in water. They are called diploblastic because their cells are arranged in two layers, an outer ectoderm and inner endoderm. They may be sessile or motile. Sessile means remain fixed to at one place. A motile maybe can be moved from one place to another. Examples are jellyfish, sea anemone. This is the picture of jellyfish. Ubaria colony. Sea animals. And Hydra. Next is phylum Platyhelminthes. They are commonly called flatworms. Basically, they are parasites. They are triploblastic animals because their body is composed of three layers: an outer ectoderm and a middle mesoderm and an inner endoderm layer. Examples are planaria, liver fluke, and tapeworm. Here is the picture of planaria. This is liver fluke. And this is tapeworm. Next phylum is phylum Nematoda. They are called roundworm because they have long cylindrical bodies with both ends pointed. They are free living as well as parasites. Their body is unsegmented. Examples are this is the picture of scales. Next phylum is phylum Annelida. They are commonly called segmented worms. Their bodies have external and internal segmentation called metameric segmentations. They are free living or ectoparasite. They have well developed system in their bodies. Examples are earthworm and leech. This is earthworm and this is leech. Next phylum is phylum Arthropoda. It is the largest phylum of kingdom Animalia. Jointed legs are present on their body and thus they are named as Arthropoda. Arthro means jointed and poda means foot. The body is covered externally with a hard covering called exoskeleton, which is made up of chitin. The body of an arthropod is divided into three regions: head, thorax and abdomen. Examples are scorpions, spiders, crabs, prawn, this is a scorpion, spiders, crab, cockroach, and centipede, prawn. These are the examples of arthropod. Metamorphosis. Basically, what is metamorphosis? Change in form and shape of an animal during its developmental stages from an egg to adult is called metamorphosis. There are two types of metamorphosis: complete metamorphosis, incomplete metamorphosis. Basically, the insects from the phylum Arthropoda go through a phenomena called metamorphosis during their life. Let's talk about complete metamorphosis. The process of complete metamorphosis completes in four stages: egg, larva, pupa, adult. This is the cycle. First stage is egg, second is larva, third one is pupa, and fourth one is adult. If you look at this picture, you can see that the adult one is totally different from the larva, right? Basically, what happened here, first of all, adult female insect lays egg. Larva, the young one, the larva that hatches out of egg is completely different from adult. It feeds actively and moves about. Pupa, after storing food inside the body, it encloses itself in a cover to become a pupa. Adult, after going through further changes, the pupa comes out of its capsule. It is now termed as adult because it resembles its parents. Examples basically are mosquitoes, houseflies, and butterflies. Incomplete metamorphosis. Process of incomplete metamorphosis consists of three developmental stages: egg, nymph, adult. Basically, this is the life cycle of grasshopper. It completes in three stages: egg, nymph, and adult. adult female insect lay eggs. The miniature young one called nymph emerges out of egg, which closely resembles the adult. It lacks wings and has immature reproductive organs. Adult. After the development of wings and maturity of reproductive organs, the nymph become adult. Examples are cockroach, honeybee, and grasshopper. In incomplete metamorphosis, the young one nymph is completely resembles to its adult. This is the basically the difference between complete and incomplete metamorphosis. Next phylum is phylum Mollusca. Mollusca is a Latin word which means soft. They have soft fleshy body covered in a mantle. The animals which present in phylum Mollusca having shell. They have foot. Examples are snail, pearl oyster, squid, octopus, and snail. Look at the picture of a snail. Here is a soft fleshy body and mantle over. Pearl oyster. Squid. And octopus. Mussel as well. And the last phylum of kingdom Animalia is phylum Echinodermata. They have rough and spiny skin. They are pentamerous. They have a unique water vascular system. They do not have head, eye, or even brain. Examples are starfish, sea cucumber, sand dollar. This is starfish, sea urchin, sand dollar, sea cucumber.